And welcome to our time together in God's presence with our worship. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "The first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Amen. Lord, have mercy. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Therefore, let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon, and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Collect. The Church's prayer for today, the 16th Sunday after Trinity. Lord of creation, whose glory is around and within us, open our eyes to your wonders, that we may serve you with reverence and know your peace at our life's end. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. It's Ezekiel chapter 18. The word of the Lord came to me. What do you mean by repeating this proverb concerning the land of Israel? The parents have eaten sour grapes, and the children's teeth are set on edge. As I live, says the Lord God, this proverb shall no more be used by you in Israel. Know that all lives are mine. The life of the parent as well as the life of the child is mine. It is only the person who sins that shall die. Yet you say, the way of the Lord is unfair. Hear now, our house of Israel, is my way unfair? Is it not your ways that are unfair? When the righteous turn away from their righteousness and commit iniquity, they shall die for it. For the iniquity that they have committed, they shall die. Again, when the wicked turn away from the wickedness they have committed, and do what is lawful and right, they shall save their life, because they considered and turned away from all the transgressions that they had committed. They shall surely live, they shall not die. Yet the house of Israel says, the way of the Lord is unfair. O house of Israel, are my ways unfair? Is it not your ways that are unfair? Therefore I will judge you, O house of Israel, all of you, according to your ways, says the Lord God. Repent and turn from all your transgressions. Otherwise, iniquity will be your ruin. Cast away from you all the transgressions that you have committed against me, and get yourselves a new heart and a new spirit. Why will you die, O house of Israel? For I have no pleasure in the death of anyone, says the Lord God. So turn and live. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians is chapter 2. If then there is any encouragement in Christ, any consolation from love, any sharing in the Spirit, any compassion and sympathy, make my joy complete. Be of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord and of one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility regard others as better than yourselves. But let each of you look not to your own interests, the interests of others. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, and emptied himself, taking the form of a servant, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and the Father, praise the Son, praise the Holy Ghost. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Holy Ghost. Praise God from blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Praise the Father,
according to Matthew, is Matthew chapter 21. Jesus said, "What do you think? A man had two sons. He went to the first and said, 'Son, go and work in the vineyard today.' He answered, 'I will not.' But later he changed his mind and went. The father went to the second and said the same. And he answered, 'I go, sir.' But he did not go. Which of the two did the will of the Father?" His disciples said, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Truly I tell you, the tax collectors, the prostitutes are going into the kingdom of God ahead of you. John the Baptist came to you in the way of righteousness, and you did not believe him. But the tax collectors and the prostitutes did believe him. And even after you saw it, you did not change your mind and believe him." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. I've got a glass of water. It's filled to the brim. In fact, it's so full up, there's absolutely no way I can get anything more into it. It's full. And being full, well, I can't make it fuller still. But what I can do, I can get rid of some of that water. Get rid of more. Get rid of more. Until it's empty. And now, see, because it's 3/4 empty, I can put more into it. It's empty. So there's room. Jesus tells us that poor in spirit is the only way that we can appreciate God, to be filled with God. If you imagine that this glass is your soul and it's absolutely full up with you, with your spirit, with yourself, if you are so full of self that you're filled to the brim, there is no space in there for God. You're full up already. You need to be poor in spirit if you are to have space in your soul for God. You need to empty self. Bit gone. That soul can have a bit of space for God. That soul can have more space for God. It is poor in spirit. It will see God. Jesus says so. This soul is so empty of self that there's no space for a lot of God. God can truly work through this soul. This soul is going to be a godly soul. This soul, because he is so full of God, is going to know God, be intimate with God, be friends with God, understand the scriptures. This soul is a lucky soul, and when it passes from this life to the next, is so filled with God that he's going to know God when he reaches heaven. There's no transition at all, really. Godliness to true God. In that reading I read a moment ago from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians, he's talking about Jesus. Jesus emptied himself so that God could fill him. He's so full of God that we say that he is God. And part of the Christian message is that we start like this, full up of self, we need to empty self so there is room for God. Sometimes we go in reverse, we fill up. Suddenly there's no space for God at all. Simple. We repent. We repent again. We become Christ-like. We become more Christ-like. We become poor in spirit. And that way, God can fill us. We affirm our faith, using the words of the Creed. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, the source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the Church. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Of your parents. without the knowledge of your parenthood and your loving care. But now I am your son, I am adopted in your family, and I can never be alone, 'cause Father God, you're there beside me.
Let us pray. Loving Heavenly Father, make us poor in spirit so that we can be filled with you. Make us brave enough, make us spiritual enough to seek you with everything. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving Heavenly Father, we pray for your church. Let your church be the sponsor, the powerhouse of self-emptying, that all your disciples, all those who seek to serve you, will be poor in spirit, so they can be filled with you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving Lord, we pray for your world. At the moment, many, many people are worried about COVID, about the pandemic and its effect upon their lives. Help them in their fear, help them to stay well. And we continue to pray for doctors and medics everywhere, those who can help. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We now pray for ourselves, for our friends and relatives. So in a moment of silence, let's place them in the intimate and loving presence of God. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who died, those whose year's mind occurs at this time, their families, their friends, any who are upset and mourn. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we gather together all these prayers using the words that Jesus himself taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. And the blessing of God the Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always. Amen. God. pleased to love and serve the Lord. Close to God. Please pray for us.